Hi viewers, welcome to our LERGP podcast. Today we are at the Northeast Lab with Bryan Hed, plant pathologist with Penn State University, and we're going to talk about Phomopsis. Because as Brian's about to tell us, last year was a little bit special in terms of being the perfect storm for Phomopsis infection in the Lake Erie region. So what made last year such a bad egg?
Well, we had long wetting periods, real long wetting periods, cold temperatures, shoot growth basically just in stasis at a very vulnerable period of time when we had about 1 to 3 inches of shoot growth. And during the first week in May, we had, depending on the exact location, about half the hours of that first week were spent with wet leaf surfaces. So it was a horrendous infection period, something we probably haven't seen. It's rare, but not unheard of. We saw something like this probably back in 2002, I think.
So with last year being such a high incidence of infection, I mean, I remember you saying it was almost every vineyard you walked in. I know for us personally, we had never seen Phomopsis that bad, even at our lab, you know, which we try to make sure is the poster child. But last year it happened to be the poster child for what can go wrong. And how is Phomopsis overwintering, and what makes last year's high incidence pose a greater risk for this early shoot season?
Well, the fact that there was shoot infection on practically every Concord vine and every Concord vineyard in the Lake Erie region means that there's a lot of inoculum tied up in the wood. That's where the fungus overwinters, in the canes, the older wood, some of the dead wood, the cordons, especially in the older wood. And you can see here real nice lesions. With all that inoculum, poised and ready to release spores this spring, we're concerned that if we have rainfall at the right time, just during the early shoot growth period, that we're going to definitely need to have those shoots protected with the fungicide at that time.
So we can see where our shoot growth was at the 1 to 3 inch stage last year. Seems that the lesions are sort of localized there. So how does, once the fruiting bodies are producing spores, how do those spores travel, and what on this cane here is at risk?
Well, the spores, of course, are washed downward primarily. They can be splashed upward a little bit, especially in driving rains. They can be worked up and infect some of the higher shoots in the trellis, but generally they just drip down or they flow down from inoculum sources, this older wood, and of course, these lesions right here are going to provide inoculum onto these buds that are at great risk of becoming infected should we have rainfall at the right time when those shoots are just beginning to bud out, anywhere from half inch shoot growth stage all the way to 5 or 6 inches of shoot growth. Between that 3 to 5 inches of shoot growth, that's generally when we consider the inflorescence is particularly vulnerable, and that's why the recommendation to apply a spray at that time. Weather doesn't always cooperate, unfortunately, and sometimes you can get rainfall like it did last year before that period of time, and a lot of farms got caught off guard, everybody did virtually, and didn't have an application of fungicide on at 1 to 2 inches when the rain came, and we got nailed with it.
So what materials do you find are most effective for Phomopsis early season?
Generally what we recommend is a mancozeb spray. Mancozeb fungicides are very effective. We don't worry about the development of resistance with them because we know we're going to use them several times more perhaps during the season. They have, I believe, only a 12 or 24 hour re-entry period. I think it's 24 hours. Whereas some of the others that also work well, like Xyrem and Captan, might have longer re-entry periods. They work well too, but Mancozeb seems to be cost effective, and I think Xyrem costs a little bit more. And that's what generally we recommend using. So.
So for growers that are worried about yields, what numbers can you cite? I mean, in a year like last year where you have really bad infections, I mean, what's the worst case scenario for yield loss?
Well, from work done at Cornell, Wayne Wilcox did some real nice work several years ago where he noticed that the shoulders of clusters were being bitten off very early in the season. And I think they estimated, hopefully I got this right, about 2 to 3 tons per acre can be lost just from that, you know, from that those early infections. And I think, you know, that particular period of time is especially critical. I know we've kind of added that spray just within the last, you know, few years, but it turns out that spray is really critical to protecting fruit, protecting against crop loss.
So would you recommend, especially in a year where we have maybe higher than normal inoculum sources, it might be prudent to put on that spray, even if you're great. I know we always plug NUA, going on to nua.cornell.edu and checking to see if you're at risk. Maybe even if it's not showing that there is a major risk, it might be prudent to just put the spray on this year anyway.
Well, it's from seeing Kevin's, you know, economic analysis, it's a very prudent spray. It's not a very expensive spray, and you know, you may not get benefit from it every single year, but you will benefit from it in the long term by applying it every year. So we recommend putting on that 3 to 5 inch shoot spray.
So the long and short of it from Bryan Hed, just do it. Spray early, get it before these spores are infecting your new emerging shoots. And you know, that yield loss off the shoulder might not be something, you know, it's not like you're watching it fall in front of the harvester necessarily. So you might not even know that yield loss has happened. But your pocketbook sure will.
Yeah.
So as usual, if you have any questions, please leave them in the comments section below, and we'll see you next time.